your students. There are two kinds of factors in any economy around the world, always. There will be two sets of factors which are responsible for upswing or downswing. The first factors are called structural and second are called cyclical. Now, economists have been debating, including the Reserve Bank of India, in its latest annual report 2018-19, that most of the reasons in case of the Indian economy are cyclical. Cyclical basically means anything which has gone up has to necessarily come down. The reason for this cyclical downswing is the excess capacity which has been created by the businesses in different sectors, whether it is automobile, or it is automobile parts, or it is business schools. There are thousands of business schools which were opened and they are waiting for the students to come. There are hundreds of universities which are not having management students. So they are having capacity, but students do not have faith in what they are doing. Likewise, you are manufacturing cars in India, Maruti, then your South Korean car, Hyundai, Honda, and Skoda, and so on and so forth. There are tens of them. Everybody wants to unveil a new car or launch a new car in India, thinking that Indian market is a growing market. But Indian market, yes, it has grown in the past, but services sector today is not growing at the same rate at which it was growing in the past. So the capacities have been created. Capacities to produce additional cars have been created in the hope that past will go on repeating itself. But past doesn't necessarily repeat. Okay, so you have excess capacity. You have more and more people who want to sell car, but people are losing jobs. Now, for why people are losing jobs? The reasons can be very many. It is very difficult to say why so many factories have been closed. It could be that people expectations regarding the profitability have gone down. Maybe the returns on investments are not as promising as they thought they would be. Maybe the entire global business environment is also indicating towards the economic slowdown, and what India is experiencing is the transportation of the feelings of slowdown in the global markets, resulting in the slowdown in the Indian market. Indian market is not insulated from the rest of the world. Please check whether the world economy is growing or has stopped growing. What is happening to China? Chinese economy is also not growing at the same rate. For 35 years, it continued to grow at 10 to 12%.
Yes, sir.
Now it is growing at say 5 to 6%, and tomorrow it may be 4 to 5%. So the economies are interlinked. They are organically linked. What happens in US travels to Europe. What happens in Europe and US travels to China. And sometime what happens in China travels to the rest of the world, because they are the major exporters. So, it could be a part of the global slowdown. It is cyclical. Now, there is one more dimension I would like to tell you. When you are saying that there is an economic slowdown, it means aggregate supply is more than aggregate demand. Now, this is also a good sign in the sense that there is no shortage of goods and services in India. Inflation rate is very low and manageable. And whatever goods you want to buy, the entire market is stuffed with all those goods. There is no shortage. So we are no longer a poor underdeveloped, developing economy. These are signs of economic maturity. That India also is facing the same problems as the developed West is facing. I do not want to speak on Pakistan economy, but you must on your own compare the two economies to find out what I am trying to convey. The rate of inflation today in the Indian economy is comparable to Europe and US. It means that aggregate demand, aggregate supply balance has gone in favor of the customer. Customer is at an advantage, but employee is not at an advantage. Now I am both a employee and I am also a customer. When I am earning money, I am an employee. When I am spending money,
I am a customer.
As a customer, I am enjoying the current situation. But as an employee, if I have a feeling that I may lose my job tomorrow, obviously there will be sense of insecurity and my consumption behavior, my expenditure pattern will be affected adversely. I would like to hold my money with myself and I will not like to put it into the marketplace, which is causing economic slowdown. So friends, sectors, you ask me which sectors? Definitely those sectors which were blooming in the last say 10 years are likely to have economic slowdown.
Automobile, FMCG.
Automobile, FMCG, white goods. By white goods, I mean refrigerators, air conditioners, washing machines. As and when your income grows, you want to move to automation. So, even this cell phones, find out whether cell phone market is also experiencing slowdown or it is not experiencing slowdown. That is an assignment I am giving to you. Find out the cell phone, because cell phones are used largely by people in your age group who are spending their parents' income and are therefore not concerned. Whereas cars are bought by the people who have earned that money over a long period of time. So see how does the market of cell phone behave in the last 6 months, which is characterized by economic slowdown, and compare it with the automobile sector. Likewise, take the case of health tourism. Health tourism basically means, are people spending less money on health and medicine, or they are spending same money or more? I don't know. You have to find out. So sometimes rhetoric is there. Rhetoric basically means everybody is talking of economic slowdown. Yes, there is a slowdown, particularly in two-wheelers, four-wheelers, commercial vehicles. So this shows that there are problems, and these problems have been created by a combination of factors. Lack of black money. Black money could be one of the reasons. It has been flushed out. Tax enforcement has become very, very severe. So many people are getting punished. Fear of law is there. Now, nobody will argue that fear of law should not be there. So GST, I am told that the collections have gone down below.
Sir, they are slightly down, not more.
But slightly down, and after 2 months they will come up.
Come up. Because the demand will create for
this festival. So the people have not paid money, they are holding, they will pay. Enforcement people will ensure that they pay. So we should not be led by rhetoric. Scientifically look at. But there is no doubt that there is a slowdown in two-wheelers, four-wheelers, commercial vehicles and so on, and these FMCG and white goods, which shows uncertainty in the mind of the earners in higher brackets, particularly those who are working in the corporate sector.
Sir, will these bank merger help in reviving the economy?
Now look, my dear friends, this bank merger has taken place after almost 40-50 years of dilly-dallying. Dilly-dallying means uncertainty. they were nationalized in 1969. And 69 se aap le lijiye 2019, it comes to how many years? 50 years.
50.
So something which has been done today to correct the situation which has existed in the last several decades, don't think that today you do it and tomorrow it will happen. It will take its own time. Banking reforms will translate themselves into certain economic gains, but not tomorrow, not in 2019, but maybe in 2025. These are the changes. These are structural changes. I started by telling you,
yes,
there are two kinds of changes which are taking place. This merger of banks is a structural reforms. Your insolvency code is a structural reform. So this government, I am not led or misled by anybody, this government has taken certain initiatives in the last several years, particularly in the last 100 days, which go to show that they are here to take the bull by horn and they are not willing to keep the problems under the carpet. So when the carpet is cleaned, lot of dust will come out of it. And people will criticize the one who has touched the carpet. But actually this carpet has been hanging fire for years and years together. So certain amount of uncertainty, inconvenience, slowdown is inevitable.
The chief economics advisor also said that.
And to expect any magical results from this mergers and amalgamations would be totally wrong. It will take its own time. That time may run into several years.
Sir, I attended one of your seminar and you predicted that the interest rate will fall down. And recently we have seen this, that the 35.6 points it has fallen. So how did you predict it?
Because I have understood the science of economics. Economics is a science.
Yes.
So I can see the writings on the wall. The way a doctor looks at your pulse and your eyes and stethoscope he uses, then he writes certain tests. After some time he is able to predict that look, this seems to be the problem. So I could very well see that if they have to revive the economy, as they have to revive because of economic slowdown, they have only two tools in their hands. One is the interest rate, another is the tax rate. So they have reduced both the tax rate and the interest rate to stimulate investment, to create a feeling in the minds of the investor that government is here to take care of you. Please come out with more confidence. Please understand that investment is always made not based on today's profit but on profit expectations. When you buy a share, don't go by what this particular share has been giving. You should think in terms of what it is capable of giving in future. Okay, whenever he makes investment, he weighs, 1,000 times he weighs, even in his dreams, what should I do? Should I make investment? Should I hold? Should I expand the same shop? Or I should sell?
The chief economics advisor, K. Subramanian, said that the economic slowdown is just an eye watch. We will be walking for 5 trillion economy to India. Will achieve that?
Getting to this 5 trillion economy is not a cakewalk.
Yes, sir.
It is not easy. It is not a matter of fiction. It requires huge effort. First of all, you have to increase investment.
Yes, sir.
In order to increase investment, you have to improve the investment climate, both for your domestic investor and for the foreign investor. Yes. So you have to go in for reform, making the entire environment more liberal, more attractive, the way China has done in the last 40 years. same way you have to do it. You have to even think in terms of designing strategies as to how you can allow the American firms, because Donald Trump is telling American companies to shift from China to some other country. Why India cannot be the hub where the American firms or the European firms can be relocated? But for that, you have to follow a very competitive policy of attracting them and then ensuring that this change is not only for 2020. This change is going to be there for 2030. So, if I want to bring you to my college as a student, I have to tell you that those who were brought in the past have already been placed, and those whom I have brought are being placed, getting placed. But you can't get a student, give him a wash, and turn him into a placeable material. For getting placed, you have to learn. You have to acquire new skills. You have to develop new insights into various subjects like finance and marketing and quantitative techniques and interpretation of data and analytics and communication and soft skills and so on and so forth. So it is only when I impress upon you, you will love to come to us. And I have to see that your hope is kept alive. And I have to see that neither you have to see I should not sleep. And I have to see that you do not sleep. We have to keep each other awake. Am I right, sir?
Yes, sir.
Then only you will get a large crop of students. Likewise, if you want investors, Indian and foreign, come forward and take risk and set up capacities. Capacity is setting up in a situation where already the existing capacity is not getting utilized. It's a very big challenge. But then we have to continuously make up.